Mr. or Mrs., I have an eviction on my record. Now, this should go without saying. You would think that this would go without saying, but it doesn't, right? In dealing with so many investors throughout the years, I've found that most investors, we all comprehend that, like, hey, if these tenants have been evicted, they're bad tenants. I shouldn't rent to them. But the caveat to that is Mr. and Mrs. Eviction kind of morphs itself into Mr. and Mrs. Let Me Explain, right? So if you're watching this video, you already know if you get Mr. and Mrs. Let Me Explain, you already got to cut them sons of bitches, right? But what investors find themselves doing is they get lured into that emotional story, right, from the eviction, right? So in a scenario where you're the property manager, you're the landlord, and you're talking to somebody, and they're like, yeah, I was evicted because I didn't feel like paying my rent to my landlord. What are you going to do, right? I think 99.9% of you out there are going to know, oh, ding, 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 this person's an asshole. I shouldn't rent to them, right? But what happens is we allow ourselves to get lured into that emotional story. They say things like, oh, yeah, my last landlord, he was a slumlord. He didn't fix up the property, this or that, right? Guys, we're not out here investing in real estate to be Captain Save-A-Ho or Save-A-Joe. Ooh, I could see the liberal keyboard warriors trying to light me up for that one already. We're investing in real estate to make money. If you want to be out there helping people, trying to right all the wrongs in the world, good for you, man. That's great. I love that. But you got to know that it is not part of your actual business. That is a charitable act. That is not a sound business decision. If you're talking about making sound business decisions, any eviction for any reason at any time is an absolute no-go, guys. Even if they pull you in and they give you this story about my last landlord, blah, 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 he was a slumlord, this or that. That's why we had to go to court, this or that, right? First of all, tenants lie a lot. People that don't pay their rent and go through evictions, 9 times out of 10, they're typically lying to you about this. But even in the off chance, the minute chance that those people are not lying to you, and say their previous landlord was a slumlord, and they really did go to like a big court battle, okay? It goes back to that. You can't be Captain Save-A-Ho, Save-A-Joe, right? You can't do that, guys, because anytime you put that tenant into your property, you have lost a little bit of leverage, right? You don't have any more leverage than at the tenant screening process. As soon as you put them in their property, you can't just remove them whenever you want, right? You might have to go through a lengthy eviction, lengthy court battle to actually get them out, right? And do you want to do that with a tenant who's already familiar with the court process, who's confident in their ability to take a landlord to court and battle them? No, because a battle just means loss of income, additional legal fees. Again, if you want to be out there saving the world, that's great, but you have to understand trying to take chances on people that have had previous evictions because maybe they confused you or actually got you to buy their story. You have to understand that the moment you place them in that unit, guys, again, you lose a little bit of leverage, right? A little bit of leverage, right? Our job is to mitigate all risks as much as we possibly can to collect that rent. You make a decision like that, you haven't mitigated your risks as much as you could, and you're at a higher probability of not getting your rent and going through that lengthy court process, which is not a profitable activity.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWiseTV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.